नमो नमः। सर्वेषां पुनरेकवारं हार्दं स्वागतम्। स्टूडेंट्स, इन टुडेज सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विथ आवर टॉपिक ऑफ प्रत्ययः एंड यू विल आल्सो गेट इंट्रोड्यूस्ड विथ अ न्यू कंपाउंड दैट इज अव्ययी भावः। सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड विथ प्रत्ययः। इन द प्रीवियस सेशन वी हैव लर्नड टू तद्धित प्रत्ययास दैट इज मतुप एंड त्व। In today's session, you are going to get introduced with a stri pratyaya, that is ta. The pratyayas which are added to masculine nouns to change them into feminine are called stri pratyaya. There are different kinds of stri pratyaya, but the important one which is included in your syllabus is ta. So let's see ta pratyaya.
Tak pratyay is used to derive feminine forms from masculine words, and this pratyay is added to akarant pullinga shabdaha, that is masculine words ending in a. While adding tak, the letters t and p are dropped and only a remains. It means while adding the suffix tak, t and p are dropped and only a is added to the words. Let's see some examples. Aja plus tap. We add only a to the word and we get the form aja. Aja means goat. Kokila plus tap. We add only a to the word and we get the form kokila. Kokila means cuckoo. Bala plus tap. We add only a to the word and we get the form bala, which means a girl.
While adding the suffix tap, though we add only a, the name of the pratyaya is to be written as ta and not a. For example, one word is given here, shishya, and you need to split the word and the pratyaya. Two options are given here, shishya plus ta and shishya plus a. The correct answer to this question is the option k, that is shishya plus ta. You can never write shishya plus a as the answer. I hope the concept is clear to you all. Now let me take you to some more examples which will help you to understand the concept of ta pratyay.
Here are some more examples with tap pratyaya. Ashva plus tap, ashva. Jyeshtha plus tap, jyeshtha. Jyeshtha means elder. Vatsa plus tap, vatsa. Krupana plus tap, krupana. Krupana means miser. Chhatra plus tap, chhatra. Uttama plus tap, uttama. Nipuna plus tap, nipuna. Prathama plus tap, prathama. If the masculine word ends with ak, then a changes to e. It means when we add tap to any word which ends with ak, that ak gets changed into ika. Let's see some examples. Balaka plus tap, Gayaka plus tap, Sevaka plus tap, Mushaka plus tap, and Pachaka plus tap. As you can see, all the words given here are ending in aka. So as per the rule, aka will get changed into ika. So Balaka plus tap, the form is Balika. Gayaka plus tap, the form is Gaika. Sevaka plus tap, the form is Sevika. Mushaka plus tap, the form is Mushika. And Pachaka plus tap, the form is Pachika. I hope the concept is clear to you all. The forms with tap pratyay are declined like lata. So the prathama vibhakti form of lata is lata, late, lataha, In the same way, the Prathama Vibhakti form of the word Gaika is Gaika, Gaike, Gaikaha.
Students, there are certain words in which aka doesn't get changed into ika or ika. I have given three examples of such words. Edaka plus ta, edaka, chataka plus ta, chataka, and upatyaka plus ta, upatyaka. As you can see, in these three examples, a doesn't get changed into e. But don't worry, there are very few such words which are exceptions to the rule. Most of the words go as per the rule. So if you will learn the exceptions, the rest part will be easy for you. So here ends the explanation of ta pratyaha. I hope you have understood it. Now get ready to solve some questions based on ta pratyaha.
Here is the question. Prakruti pratyayau sanyojya vibhajyava likhata. Students, you can pause the video, think about the answer, and once it is done, you can go to the part where the answers are displayed. The first question is, Radha pathane praveena plus tap asti. The next one is, Taha sarvaha balaka plus tap santi. The next question is, Asyaha anuja plus tap nalini asti. The next one is, Kokila madhura swarena gayati. The next question is, Ganga pavitra nadi asti. And the last one is, Naika abhinayam karoti. Are you ready with your answers? Let's check them. Radha pathane praveena plus tap asti. The answer is the option G, praveena. Taha sarvaha balaka plus tap santi. The correct answer is the option kh, balikaha. Asyaha anuja plus tap nalini asti. The answer is the option G, anuja. Kokila madhura swarena gayati. The answer is the option kh, kokila plus tap. Ganga pavitra nadi asti. And the answer is the option k, pavitra plus tap. Naika abhinayam karoti. And the answer is the option g, nayaka plus tap. I hope your answers are correct.
So students, now let me take you to our next topic of discussion, that is Samasaha. But before we proceed, let me tell you an important thing. As per the revised syllabus prescribed by CBSE, some compounds have been omitted from your syllabus. And they are Samahara Dvandvaha, Ekashesha Dvandvaha and Bahuvrihihi. I'll repeat. Samahar Dvandva Samas, Ekashesha Dvandva Samas and Bahuvrihi Samas have been omitted from your syllabus. It means you are supposed to learn only three compounds. Itaretar Dvandvaha, Avyai Bhavaha and Vibhakti Tatpurushaha. Out of these three, the first one, that is Itaretar Dvandva Samas, has already been learnt by us. In today's session, we are going to learn the next one, that is Avyayi Bhavaha. So let's see Avyayi Bhav Samasaha. In Avyayi Bhav Samas, the first word, that is Purvapadam, is considered important. And this Purvapadam is always an indeclinable or Avyayam. The whole compound word also becomes indeclinable. It means the whole compound is used as an indeclinable or avyaya padam. The most important point is the compound word is always in Napunsakalingam Ekavachanam. It never changes its form. It is always in Napunsakalingam Ekavachanam. And the meaning of the first word is explained in the Vigraha of the compound. The question is, which indeclinables can be the first word of Avyaybhava Samasaha? Here is the answer. The indeclinables such as Prati, Yatha, Upa, Nir, Sa, which stands for Saha, and Anu can be the first word of Avyaybhava Samasaha. Students, now recognizing the Avyaybhava Samas has become easier, right? Because the compound word will always be beginning with any one of these indeclinables and it will always be in Napunsakalingam Ekavachanam. Let's try to understand it with the help of some examples.
Pratidinam, Pratigruham, Pratyekam. These three words are used in Napunsakalingam Ekavachanam and the first word of these compounds is Prati. So these three are the examples of Avyaibhava Samasaha. Yathakalam, Yathecham, Yathashakti. These three words are also used in Napunsakalingam Ekavachanam. The word Yathashakti is used like Vari. As these three words are in Napunsakalingam and the first word of these compounds is Yatha, so these three are also the examples of Avyaibhava Samasaha. Upavruksham, Upagangam, Upakrushnam. These three words are in Napunsakalingam Ekavachanam and the first word of these three is Upa, so these three words are also the examples of Avyaibhava Samasaha. Let's see some more examples. Nirjalam, Nirmanushyam, Nishkantakam. In these three examples, the first word of the compounds is Nir. In the third one, Nishkantakam, Sandhi has taken place due to which Nir has got changed into Nish. Sachitram, Sadhanam, Sadayam. In these three examples, the first member of the compound is Sa, which stands for Saha. And in the examples Anuratham, Anumrugam and Anugunam, the first member of the compound is Anu. As we can see, all these compound words are beginning with indeclinables and all the compound words are in Napunsakalingam Ekavachanam. So these words are the examples of Avyaibhava Samasaha.
Now we are going to see how to do the Vigraha of Avyaibhava Samasaha. As I have told you earlier, the meaning of the first word is explained in the Vigraha of Avyaibhava. For that, we need to take the help of some words which are not even used in the compound. It means the dissolution of Avyaibhava Samas is dependent on the first word of the compound. Let's see how to dissolve Avyaibhava Samasaha.
In Avyaibhava Samas, the indeclinable Prati is used in the sense of every. When Prati stands as the first word of the compound can be dissolved in two ways. The first one is, we have to mention the second word of the compound in Saptami Vibhaktihi twice. Or the another way is, we have to mention the second word of the compound twice in Dvitiya Vibhaktihi and the word Prati or Iti is to be added at the end. Let's try to understand it with the help of some examples. Pratidinam. The dissolution is dine dine, or the same compound can be dissolved as dinam dinam prati or dinam dinam iti. Pratidinam means every day. Pratigruham, the dissolution of the compound is gruhe gruhe. The same compound can be dissolved as gruham gruham prati और गृहम गृहम इति। प्रत्येकम, द रिजोल्यूशन इज एकम एकम इति। आई होप द कॉन्सेप्ट इज क्लियर टू यू ऑल। द मीनिंग ऑफ द वर्ड यथा इज अकॉर्डिंग टू। When yatha stands as the first word of the compound, in the dissolution, the second word of the compound is to be mentioned in dvitiya vibhaktihi and the word anatikramya is to be written next to it. For example, yatha kalam, the dissolution is kalam anatikramya. Yathecham, the dissolution is ichham anatikramya. यथा शक्ति, द रिजोल्यूशन इज शक्तिम अनतिक्रम्य। स्टूडेंट्स, द कंपाउंड वर्ड इज ऑफ न्यूटर जेंडर। इट डजेंट मीन दैट ऑल द वर्ड्स यूज्ड इन द कंपाउंड आर ऑफ न्यूटर जेंडर। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इन द सेकेंड वन यथेच्छम, द वर्ड इच्छा इज ऑफ फेमिनाइन जेंडर। इन द सेम वे in yathashakti, the word shakti is originally of feminine gender. So in the dissolution, the words are to be written as per their original gender. The next one is upa. Upa is used in the sense of near. When upa stands as the first word of the compound, in the dissolution, the second word is to be mentioned in Shashti Vibhaktihi and it should be followed by the word Samipam. For example, upa vruksham, the dissolution is Vrukshasya Samipam. Upa gangam, the dissolution is Gangayaha Samipam. Upakrushnam, the dissolution is Krushnasya Samipam. Let's see the next one. The next one is Nir. The indeclinable Nir is used in the sense of Abhavah, that is absence. In the dissolution, the second word is to be mentioned in Shashti Vibhaktihi and it should be followed by the word Abhavah. For instance, Nirjalam, the dissolution is Jalasya Abhavah. Nirmanushyam, the dissolution is Manushyanam Abhavah. Nishkantakam, the dissolution is Kantakanam Abhavah. I hope you have understood it. Let's move on to the next indeclinable. The next one is Sa, which stands for Saha. It is used to express the meaning with. In the resolution, the second word is to be mentioned in Tritiya Vibhaktihi and it is followed by the word Sahitam. For example, Sachitram, the Vigraha is Chitrena Sahitam. Sadhanam, the resolution is Dhanena Sahitam. Sadayam, the resolution is Dayaya Sahitam. In the compound Sadayam, the second word is originally of feminine gender. So in the dissolution, it is used as per its original gender. The next indeclinable is Anu. Anu has two meanings, after or behind, and suitable to or appropriate for. As it has two meanings, two dissolutions are suggested for the words which are beginning with the indeclinable Anu. The first one is, the second word is to be mentioned in Shashti Vibhaktihi and it should be followed by the word Paschat. And the second one is, the second word is to be written in Shashti Vibhaktihi and it should be followed by the word Yogyam. Now which one of these two should be used is dependent on the meaning of the compound word. Let's try to understand it with the help of some examples. Anuratham, Anumrugam, Anugunam, these three examples are beginning with the indeclinable anu. Now let's see the meanings of these words. Anuratham, janaha anuratham agachhan. People went behind the chariot. In anuratham, the indeclinable anu is used to express the meaning behind. Anumrugam, Ramah anumrugam dhavati sma. Ram ran after the deer. In this example, the word anu is used to express the meaning after. Anugunam, sah anugunam vyavaharati. He behaves in a way which is appropriate for his virtues. In this example, the word anu is used to express the meaning suitable to or appropriate for. Now, let's see the dissolution of these words. Anuratham, the dissolution is rathasya paschat. Anumrugam, the dissolution is mrugasya paschat. And anugunam, the vigraha is gunanam yogyam. I hope you have understood it.
Now we will see how to make the samasta padam when the vigraha is given to us.
Avyay bhav samas is always used in napunsakalingam ekavachanam. While making the compound word, this point is to be kept in mind. So if the second word of the compound is akarantah or akarantah shabdah, then in napunsakalingam, the compound word is to be used like phalam. If the second word of the compound is ikarantah or ikarantah shabdah, then the compound word is to be used like vari. And if the second word of the compound is ukarantah or ukarantah shabdah, then in napunsakalingam, the compound word is to be used like madhu. Let's try to understand it with the help of some examples. Sthane sthane. Here, the moola shabdah of sthane is sthana. By seeing the dissolution, we can say that the first word of the compound will be prati. We have to add this prati before the word sthana, and thus we get the compound word pratisthanam. Matim anatikramya. The mool shabda of matim is mati, which has to be used in napunsakalingam. The word yatha is to be added at the beginning, and thus we get the compound word yathamati. The next example is guroho samipam. The mool shabda of the word guroho is guru, which has to be used in napunsakalingam. The first word of the compound will be upa, and thus we get the compound word upaguru. The next one is makshikanam abhavah. The original word or moola shabdah of the word makshikanam is makshika, which has to be used in napunsakalingam in the compound. The first word of the compound will be nir, and thus we get the compound word nirmakshikam. Dharmena sahitam. Here, the moola shabdah of the word dharmena is dharma, which has to be used in napunsakalingam, like phalam. And the first member of the compound will be sa. And thus we get the compound word sa dharmam. Rupasya yogyam. The moola shabdah of the word rupasya is rupa, which will be used in napunsakalingam ekavachanam. The first member of the compound is anu, and thus we get the compound word anurupam.
So here ends the explanation of avyayi bhava samasah. I hope you have understood it. Now get ready to solve some questions based on avyayi bhava.
हियर इज द क्वेश्चन. रेखांकित पदानाम समासम विग्रहम वा कुरुत. स्टूडेंट्स यू कैन पॉज द वीडियो एंड कैन थिंक अबाउट द आंसर्स. द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज कार्यम निर्दोषम भवेत इत्यर्थम सह प्रयतते. द नेक्स्ट वन इज विद्यालये मासम मासम इति परीक्षा भवति. काकः साट्टहासम उक्तवान. मुनिः गंगायाः समीपं तपः करोति. एंड द लास्ट वन इज सः यथाविधि शास्त्रं शिक्षते. I hope you are ready with your answers. Let's check them. Karyam nirdosham bhavet ityartham sah prayatate. The dissolution of the compound nirdosham is doshanam abhavah. The next one is vidyalaye masam masam iti pariksha bhavati. And the answer is the option k pratimasam. काकः साट्टहासम उक्तवान. द डिसोल्यूशन ऑफ द कंपाउंड साट्टहासम इज अट्टहासेन सहितम. मुनिः गंगायाः समीपं तपः करोति. द कंपाउंड वर्ड इज उपगंगम. सः यथाविधि शास्त्रं शिक्षते. The dissolution of the compound yathavidhi is vidhim anatikramya. I hope your answers are correct.
So this concludes the focus of discussion today. We will meet again with the next part. Dhanyavadaha, punarmilamaha.